Hello viewers and welcome to First PUC Accountancy class. In the previous classes, we have already discussed and analyzed how to pass the journal entries in the books of any business organization. We will further analyze the situation in a particular business organization and we will try to record these transactions in the books of a business organization. The link for the question is provided in the video. You can use the link for referring the question. The question is, journalize the following transactions in the books of a business organization for the year 2017 November month. The series of transactions in a business have been listed out. Based on these transactions, we have to pass the journal entries. November 1st, business started with cash rupees 1,50,000 and goods rupees 50,000. First, we have to identify the accounts involved in the transaction. They have started business by investing cash as well as goods. So, the accounts involved in the transaction are, they have invested cash, they have invested goods, nothing but stock. We consider the goods invested as stock, and the one more account is capital account. Cash is an asset, stock is also an asset, capital is capital. Next step, we have to see whether the value of these classes of accounts is increasing or decreasing. Whenever you start a business by investing cash, cash balance will increase. So the asset value increases. The rule says that increase in an asset has to be debited. So cash account is debited. Stock is also an asset. You have invested stock in your business, stock value also increases. So the asset value increases, increase in an asset has to be debited. Capital is capital. You are starting your business by investing capital, the capital value also increases. So the capital value increases. The rule says that whenever the capital value increases, it has to be credited. So the journal entry will be cash account debit, stock account debit to capital account. Date is 2017, November 1st. The entry will be cash account debited, stock account debited to capital account. Amount of cash invested is 1,50,000. Stock or the goods is 50,000. So the total amount of capital invested is rupees 2 lakh. Next, you have to write the narration. Started business with cash and goods. Started business with cash and goods. Then draw a line which indicates the transaction has ended. Second transaction, on November 3rd, purchased goods from Arish rupees 30,000. Now the two accounts involved in the transaction are purchases and Arish account. The transaction clearly suggests the goods have been purchased from Arish on credit basis. There is no information related to the cash aspect. That means we assume that this particular transaction is a credit transaction. That means Arish is a creditor in the transaction. We have the responsibility to make payment to Arish. Now, purchases is an expense for the business. Arish is a creditor, nothing but a liability. When you make purchase of any goods, your expense value will increase. So the expense value will increase. The rule says that when the expense increases, it has to be debited. So purchases account will be debited. Arish is a liability. We have the responsibility to make payment to Arish. So our liability value also increases. The rule says that when the liability value increases, it has to be credited. So the journal entry will be purchases account debited to Arish account. So November 3rd, 2017, entry will be purchases account debited to Arish account. Amount of purchase is 30,000. You would write the narration. Purchased goods from Arish. Third transaction, November 5th, sold goods for cash rupees 12,000. Goods have been sold on cash basis and the amount of sales is 12,000. Two accounts involved in the transaction are cash account and sales account. Cash is an asset, sales is an income or revenue. When you sell the goods, you receive cash. Cash is an asset. Asset value increases. So the rule says that when the asset value increases, it has to be debited. Sales is an income or revenue for the business. The business income or revenue increases. Rule says that when the income value increases, it has to be credited. So the journal entry will be cash account debited to sales account. November 5th, cash account debited to sales account. Amount of sales is 12,000. Next, write the narration. Goods sold for cash. So the page in the journal book has ended. That means you have to calculate the total of the particular page. That total will be carried forward to the next page in the journal book. So the total will be 1,50,000 plus 50,000, 2,00,000 plus 30,000, 2,30,000 plus 12,000, 2,42,000. So this total of 2,42,000 will be carried forward to the next page in the journal book. So total is 2,42,000. So the total brought forward from the last page is 2,42,000. Record the same total in the next page. Total brought forward 2,42,000 on both debit as well as credit column. Next transaction, November 8th, purchase furniture for cash rupees 5,000. purchased furniture worth rupees 5000 and the value as paid in the form of cash. Now the two accounts involved in the transaction are furniture account and cash account. Furniture is an asset, cash is also an asset. When you buy a furniture, furniture value increases. So the asset value increases. Rule says that when the asset value increases, it has to be debited. You are paying cash, cash is going out of the business, cash balance will come down or it will reduce. So the asset value reduces. The rule says that when the asset value reduces, it has to be credited. So the journal entry will be furniture account debited to cash account. November 8, 2017. The entry will be furniture account debited to cash account. Amount of purchase is 5000. On both debit as well as credit column, record 5000. Write the narration. Furniture purchased for cash. Next transaction on November 10, cash paid to Arish on account rupees 15,000. On November 3rd, you have purchased goods from Arish worth rupees 30,000 on credit basis. Now you are making payment to Arish. Out of 30,000, 15,000 is being paid. That means you are paying in installment. 15,000 rupees is being paid to Arish in the form of cash. So the two accounts involved are, one is Arish account and one more cash account. You have paid cash to Arish. Arish is the liability creditor, cash is an asset. Now you are paid to the extent of 15,000, to that extent your creditor's value comes down or the liability value is decreasing. So the rule says that when the liability value decreases, it has to be debited. You are paying cash, cash is an asset, cash is going out of the business, the asset value reduces. When the asset value reduces, it has to be credited. So the journal entry will be Arish account debited to cash account. On November 10th, Arish account debited to cash account. Amount is 15,000. Amount is 15,000. Paid cash to Arish. Paid cash to Arish. Next transaction on November 13, paid sundry expenses rupees 200. Now sundry expenses are nothing but other expenses in the business. Now these other expenses have been paid worth rupees 200. Two accounts involved are sundry expenses and cash account. Sundry expense is an expense, cash is an asset. Your expense value is increasing. When the expense value increases, it has to be debited. You are paid in the form of cash, cash is an asset. Asset value reduces or decreases, decrease in the asset has to be credited. So the journal entry will be sundry expenses account debited to cash account. On November 13th, sundry expenses account, nothing but the other expenses in the business, account debited to cash account. Amount is 200 rupees. Paid sundry expenses. Paid sundry expenses. One more page of the journal book has ended. Next, we have to calculate the total, and the same total has to be carried forward to the next page in the journal book. So now we'll calculate the total of this particular page. 2,42,000 plus 5,000, 2,47,000, 2,47,000 plus 15,000, 2,62,000, 2,62,000 plus 200, 2,62,200, 2,62,200. This is the total that will be carried forward to the next page. So the total brought forward from the last page is 2,62,200. Record the same total. Total brought forward 2,62,200 on both debit as well as credit column. Next transaction on November 15, cash sales rupees 15,000. November 15th, we have sold goods and we have received cash. So the two accounts involved are cash account and sales account. Cash is an asset, sales is an income or revenue. When you sell the goods, you receive the cash, cash balance increases. So the asset value is increasing. Increase in an asset has to be debited. You are selling the goods, your income is increasing. The rule says that when the income value increases, it has to be credited. So the journal entry will be cash account debited to sales account. And the date of transaction is November 15. So 2017, November 15, entry is cash account debited to sales account. To sales account, amount of sales is 15,000. 15,000. Write the narration. Goods sold. Goods sold for cash. Goods sold for cash. Next transaction on November 18th, deposited into bank rupees 5,000. Cash has been deposited into your bank account. So the two accounts involved are bank account and cash account. Bank is an asset, cash is also an asset. When you deposit cash into your bank account, bank balance will increase. So the asset value is increasing, increase in an asset has to be debited. You are depositing cash, cash is going out of your business, cash balance reduces or it decreases. So the rule says that when the asset value decreases, it has to be credited. So the journal entry will be bank account debited to cash account on November 18th. November 18, bank account debited to cash account. Amount deposited is 5,000. 5,000. Cash deposited into bank. Cash deposited into bank. Next transaction on November 20th, drew cash for personal use rupees 1,000. The owner of the business organization has withdrawn or he has taken back the amount for his private or personal use. Now the two accounts involved are capital, or it is the drawings amount, drawings, and cash account. Drawings is a part of capital, cash is an asset. When you are withdrawing the amount for your personal use, nothing but out of the capital invested, you are taking back some amount. To that extent, the capital value reduces. So the capital balance reduces. Rule says that when the capital balance reduces, it has to be debited. So you are withdrawing cash, cash is going out of the business, cash balance also reduces. Asset value decreases, decrease in an asset has to be credited. So the journal entry will be drawings account debited to cash account. November 20th. Drawings account debited to cash account. Amount of drawings is 1000 rupees. Write the narration. Cash withdrawn for personal use. Cash withdrawn for personal use. Next, you have to calculate the total of this particular page and carry forward the same total to the next page. So the total carried forward will be 2,83,500. 2,83,500. 2,83,500. Total carried forward. So the total brought forward from the last page is 2,83,500. Record the same total. Total brought forward 2,83,500. 2,83,500. Next transaction on November 22nd, cash paid to Arish in full settlement of account 14,700. Earlier on November 3rd, we have purchased goods from Arish worth rupees 30,000, out of which 15,000 is paid in first installment, remaining balance is 15,000. Now out of this 15,000, we have paid 14,700 as the final settlement. 15,000 minus 14,700, there is a balance of 300 rupees. This balance is nothing but the discount we have received. We were supposed to pay 15,000, but we have paid less, that is 14,700. The difference amount of 300 rupees is the discount received. So the accounts involved in the particular transaction are, we have paid to Arish, who is a liability or a creditor. We have paid in the form of cash, and we have received discount. Nothing but discount received. So Arish is a liability creditor, cash is an asset, discount received is an income. We have paid to Arish, to that extent our liability decreases. Decrease in the liability has to be debited. We have paid cash, cash is going out of the business, cash balance reduces, asset value decreases, it has to be credited. Discount received is nothing but a gain for the business. Our income or gain value increases, increase in the income has to be credited. So the journal entry will be Arish account debited to cash account to discount received account. on 2017 November 22nd. The entry will be Arish account debited to cash account to discount account. The amount which was supposed to pay to Arish was 15,000, out of which we have paid 14,700 cash. The remaining balance of 300 is the discount received. The narration will be paid to Arish in full settlement. Paid to Arish in full settlement or final settlement of his account. Next transaction on November 25th, goods sold to Nitesh rupees 7,000. Clearly it is mentioned in the transaction, it is a credit transaction. The name of the person, that is Nitesh, is mentioned and no information about cash aspect is given. Therefore, we assume that this particular transaction is a credit transaction. So the two accounts involved in the transaction are sales account and Nitesh account. Now, sales is an income or revenue. We have the right to receive the amount from Nitesh in the near future. Nitesh becomes an debtor, which means an asset. Now, when we make the sales, our income or revenue increases. The rule says that when the income increases, it has to be credited. Nitesh is an asset in the form of debtors. Our debtors' value increases. Rule says that when the asset value increases, it has to be debited. So the journal entry will be Nitesh account debited to sales account. November 25th, Nitesh account debited. Nitesh account debited to sales account. Amount of credit sales is 7,000. 7,000. Write the narration. Goods sold to Nitesh. Goods sold to Nitesh. Next transaction on November 26th, cartage paid rupees 200. Now, cartage is nothing but an expense for the business. You are paying the cartage expenses. So the two accounts involved are cartage account and cash account. So the two accounts involved in the transaction are cartage account, which is an expense, and cash account. Cartage and cash account. Cartage is an expense, cash is an asset. When you make the payment of cartage expenses, your expenses will increase. It has to be debited. Cash balance will reduce. Cash is going out of the business. The rule says that it has to be credited. So the journal entry will be cartage account debited to cash account. Date is November 26th, 2017. Cartage account debited to cash account. Amount of cartage expense is 200 rupees. Write the narration. Paid cartage expenses. Paid cartage expenses. Next, we are supposed to calculate the total of this particular page. That is the total carried forward so the total carried forward will be 3,05,700 rupees 3,05,700 rupees total brought forward from the last page is 3,05,700 so total brought forward 3,05,700 next transaction on November 27th paid rent 1,500 so 2017 November 27th the two accounts involved are rent account and cash account rent is an expense cash is an asset so whenever you are making payment of rent your expense value increases increase in an expense has to be debited cash is an asset asset balance reduces cash is going out of the business rule says that it has to be credited so the entry will be rent account debited to cash account rent account debited to cash account amount of rent is 1,500 narration paid rent November 29th received cash from Nitesh rupees 6,800 and discount allowed rupees 200 earlier we have sold goods to Nitesh on credit basis the value of sales was 7,000 rupees Now we have received the amount from Nitesh that is 6,800 only and we have given a discount of rupees 200. So the accounts involved are cash account, Nitesh account and discount allowed account. That means business is giving the discount. Cash is an asset, Nitesh is a debtor. Is also an asset discount allowed is an expense or loss for the business we are receiving cash from Nitesh cash balance increases increase in an asset has to be debited Nitesh is an asset a debtor to that extent the debtor's value reduces or decreases it has to be credited and discount allowed is an expense or it is a loss expense value increases it has to be debited So the general entry will be cash account debited, discount allowed account debited to Nitesh account on November 29th. November 29, 2017, we have received cash, so cash account debited. We have given a discount, discount allowed account debited. To Nitesh account amount of cash received is 6,800 discount allowed is 200 rupees total amount is 7,000 rupees so the narration will be received cash from Nitesh and allowed a discount next transaction on November 30th salary paid rupees 3000 two accounts involved are salary which is paid to the employees and it is paid in the form of cash So cash account. Salary is an expense. Cash is an asset. Expense value increases. It has to be debited. Cash is an asset. Asset balance reduces. It has to be credited. So November 30th, entry will be salary account debited to cash account. November 30th, 2017, salary account debited to cash account. Amount of salary paid is 3000 rupees. 3000. Write the narration. Paid salary. Now all the transactions related to the business have been recorded. Next step, we have to calculate the total of all the transactions. Final total. So the final total is 3,17,200. 3,17,200. 3,17,200.